Good evening, guys. So today's our concept is working with smart control. Working with smart control. So far, we have seen how to configure the Gaia OS and promote it as a either management server and gateway. Okay, so as you are aware, my laptop is the control machine, and we having two VM virtual machines working. One is CPU management, that is the management server with the IP address 192.168.200.200. So we are logging into the checking the interface IP address is ether 0. Okay, so the IP address is 192.168.200.200, which can be reachable from my console machine. That means I can ping from my console machine to the management server. So coming to the firewall, we are specifying the host name as GW1. So the host name is GW1. The IP address is here. Show interface. I have multiple interfaces, so I am checking for specific ether 0. Okay, I have configured two interfaces for gateway. One is internal communication, one we will configure for the external. Okay, so currently ether 0 is the management interface. The IP address is 192.168.200.100. Okay, if you try to ping that IP address, you will see request timeout, because now the firewall is now the gateway is promoted as a firewall, so it will perform implicit deny, which means the ping test will be get dropped. Okay, so the testing of ping will be denied, whereas I can access the device using web UI. So I am logging into 192.168.200.100. Okay, I am giving the username and the password. So I have the access to the firewall using web GUI, whereas the ping packet are getting denied. So let us move to the smart console. So as you guys are aware that we can download the smart console application from our gateway or from our management server. Okay, in the maintenance, we have an option called download smart console. Okay, from there you can able to download the file. Okay, currently the database has been logged by the CLI. That's what you are seeing, the configuration is logged. Okay, to obtain the log, you need to click here and click S button. Okay, so from there you can download the file. Okay, already I have downloaded and installed the file smart console. So this is the first time I am trying to log in using my username and password to the machine. So it will ask for the fingerprint. Okay, let me show you how the fingerprints looks like. So the application is launching, about to launch. It will take a few minutes to load. Okay, so it is asking for our username, that is, we are going with the same username admin, and the password what we are using, pass 123. Now it's connecting to the server 192.168.200.200, which is the management server. Okay, so here comes the fingerprint to authenticate. It's showing CHEN OUCH port mail BORG BANA BOLT. Like that, it is showing the fingerprints. Where we can see the fingerprint means you need to go to the management server, okay, and execute the command cpconfig. Okay, if you are executing the command cpconfig, you will have a list of options, okay, like 1 to 9 list will be there. Okay, from that you can select the list number 7, certificate fingerprint. Okay, so here also the same one, CHENOUCH port mail. Okay, both are looks the same. So we can proceed, click the proceed button. This will connect to our management server using smart console. To exit from the cpconfig, you need to give the command number 9, that will exit you from the cpconfig. Okay. Okay, so we have launched the smart console to the management server 192.168.200.200. Here you can see the list of gateways or the log server, whatever may be we have added, will be in the gateways and server end. Okay, so here you can add a new node by clicking this option. So if you want to add a gateway, you can specify clicking on the gateway and specifying the IP address and giving the SIC, secure internal communication IP address, you can able to establish a trust between the management server and a gateway. Okay, so if you want to add a cluster combination of two boxes, you can configure the cluster, okay, VXS, and you have a more options. Okay, so let me show you one by one. So in the gateways and server, we can see the list of nodes we are going to about to add, and the security and policies, there we will see the access control list and netting, if we have enabled blade such as application blade, those all things, the things relevant to the policies will be come into the security and policies. Okay, so currently we are seeing a one rule. The rule is called as cleanup rule, which means in every environment there is a last rule to log and deny all the communications except the rules wherever we have allowed. Okay, what I am coming to tell is the cleanup rule will perform a deny to any. So here you can see currently we have only one rule. So if we try to communicate from a source to destination, this rule comes to picture and deny the communication. So the source should be any, destination is any, whatever may be the service ports, even 443 80 HTTP FTP, whatever may be, that will be get dropped. Okay, and the tracking is not enabled. If you want to enable the track, we can add the log. Okay, if you are clicking the log button, this will generate a log in the log and monitor. So in the log and monitoring, you can see the logs where the traffic is initiated from the source to destination, whether the action is allowed or dropped, we can see in the log session. So here you can see the list of logs loaded from the management. So the origin is the management, that is 192.168.200.200, which is our IP trying to reach the updates.checkpoint.com, and it is not reachable because we are not in configured the default gateway, as well as the proper communication is not routed, so it is not able to reach the website trying to connect. So let us go back. How to add the gateway to the management server? Okay, so you need to go to the gateways and server. Okay, click the option new. We are going to add a gateway. Okay, before adding the gateway, let us test the first level of testing between the management server and the gateway. Okay, it will be you and request time mode or destination mode not reachable. Let us see. Think. .168.200.100 is our gateway. Okay, executing the ping test. Okay, we got the error as 100 packet loss. Okay, 2 packets are trying to transmit and we are seeing 100 packet packet loss. Due to the reason is now the box is changed to a firewall. Okay, so in order to add a gateway, we have two options. One is wizard mode, or you can use a classic mode. Okay, I am going to use a wizard mode. Okay, wizard mode means it will ask you next step, whereas in a classic mode, in a single screenshot, you can able to add everything and just the connectivity. Okay, so currently I have clicked the option not a wizard mode. What is the other mode? As specified, we have two options. Either we can use the wizard mode or classic mode. Currently, I have selected the option classic mode. You can add a gateway in a single device itself. So what are the things mandatory means? Okay, the IP address is very much mandatory, and the SIC, secure internal communication, is very much mandatory to manage a gateway from the management server. Okay, so you can give any name. Okay, so I'm going with the name GW1. I'm using the name GW1. If you want to modify the color of the object which we are creating, okay, understand one thing, everything in the checkpoint is a concept called objects. Okay, so if you are adding a gateway, it will be an object. If you are adding a network, that will be an object. If you are adding a host, that will be another object. So now we are creating an object called gateway1. Okay, you can select a color for your object, whatever may be. You can select, I am going with the color blue. Okay, and the IP address of the gateway we are using is 192.168.200.100, which is the IP address. Okay, and we can click the communicate button, communication. While executing the communication button, we are getting a prompt to specify the SIC, secure internal communication, password. So for the testing purpose, we are using the same password in all the places. So I am giving pass 123, pass 123. Okay, so we are using the password. So if you want to check, if you want to modify your SIC password, okay, unfortunately, if you forgot the SIC password, you can go to the specific gateway. Okay, so I am going to my gateway one, that is admin, pass 123. Okay, here also you need to execute the same command, cpconfig. Okay, previously I have told you cpconfig to check the fingerprints. To modify the SIC, secure internal communication, also we will execute the cpconfig. The place in which we are executing the command is different. First time we have executed in the management server, currently we are working in the firewall. Okay, so here you can see the option. Option number 5, secure internal communication. If you are clicking the option number 5, okay, it is asking you, would you like to change the activation key? If you forget, you can specify Y and set a new password. Okay, currently I have the password, so I am not specifying. So in the future you can use. Okay, so cpconfig is the command, and selecting the option 5 to modify the secure internal communication passphrase. Okay, so I am exiting out and trying to, oh my god, smart console is closed. No, so here you can test the initiate. Okay, I am initiating the communication. Now the communication, the trust is established between the management server and the gateway. So here you can see the trust is established. So understand one thing properly, if you want to establish a proper trust between a management and the gateway, you should have a proper SIC, secure internal communication. So using a single management server, you can manage n number of gateways. So we are ready to go. Now you are seeing that trust is established. Currently we have configured only ETHOS 0, so it is automatically get the information of the gateway. Okay, totally we have Etho 0 and Etho 1. I have configured only Etho 0 and Etho 1 is not yet configured. So it is getting the information of Etho 0. That's how the topology is updated. Okay, so here it's clearly saying the classical wizard shows that trust is established. Okay, let me show you in the wizard mode. Okay, sorry guys, instead of clicking OK, I have pressed cancel. So after clicking cancel, it is asking me, you established trust for this object. So as I told you, a new object is created. If you want to continue, if you are specifying yes, what happened means it will be get erased. I am going with no. Okay, and specifying click OK. Now the new object will be created in the name of GW1, that is our gateway 1. Okay, no interfaces are defined, so we don't have yet configured the proper interfaces. That's what it is showing. I am continuing with yes. We are ready to go. Our new gateway is added. So currently you are seeing two number of objects. One is the management object, another one is the gateway object. Okay, both are in the gateways and servers. So one is the server and another one is added as a gateway. And here you can see the active blades. Okay, this represents, okay, if I want to explain the name of the gateway, whatever the object name we specified is the name here. Okay, it's not the exact host name. You can use any name for reference. And the IP address, okay, 192.168.200.100, which is the gateway, and 200.200 is the management server. The version we are running is 8.0.1.0. Okay, the Gaia version we are using is 8.0.1.0. The beta version right now is 8.0.4.0. Okay, we'll see later how to migrate the OS to 8.0.1.0 to 8.0.3.0 or 8.0.4.0. And here you can see the blades. Okay, as we enabled the firewall, it is default enabled with the firewall blade. Okay, you can enable VPN blades. Okay, identity awareness blade, application blade, like that. You can add multiple blades. Okay, we'll show you those things. If coming to the management, we have two blades. One is network policy management and another one is log and status. Okay, and the hardware we are using is open server. Okay, so let me show you again how to add any node using a wizard mode. So far we have seen how to add a node using a classic mode. Now let us see how to add a gateway with wizard mode. So click the option wizard mode instead of the classic mode. Click the option wizard mode. So wizard means one step next, like that. It will have a multiple wizards to configure our device. Okay, so here the first wizard is asking you the gateway name. So you can specify any name. Okay, just for example, I am anyhow going to cancel this one. Adding gateway 2. Okay, you can give the IP address, whatever may be the IP, 192.168.100.100. Okay, if you are configured with the dynamic IP address, you can specify dynamic IP address. Click next. The next wizard will ask you the trust communication between the source. So the platform it is asking. So you can specify, if you have any appliance, you can specify the application appliances, whereas if it's an open server, you can specify the VM servers as open servers. So clicking the next option will request you the SIC password, secure internal communication password, which is configured. So you can specify the one-time password and click next. Okay, then it will give you the next wizard, that there we can enable the blades. By default, firewall blade is enabled as I specified here. Okay. So I am canceling this wizard mode. To let you know, I have shown you the wizard mode. Okay. So it's trying to add. So whenever you are adding any notes, it will be comes here. So let us conclude the session here. So today the topic we have seen is how to work with the smart console, and I have specified you how to add a gateway to the management server. So the important thing is SIC communication. Okay, so I'm stopping the class here. We'll see next topic later.